Hello everyone, welcome to Passion Talk, an initiative by Times Passion Trails. It is an exclusively curated series of masterclasses where experts talk about their art, the inspiration, the stories, and their passion behind it. Our experts have specially crafted the subject for their masterclasses, sharing unique pearls of wisdom only they bring to the world. Get ready to discover flavors of traditional cuisines and their origin, unlock the secrets of Sufi music, and understand why it touches your soul the way it does. Understand the art of mixology, get to know how cooking is nothing short of creating a sensory masterpiece, and let a music maestro reveal the mysteries of poetry and music. Get ready to be inspired. Our masterclass today is Cartoons as Chronicles with Nilab Banerjee. Nilab is a leading illustrator in the country who comes from a family of cartoonists. His work under the name of Nilab Toons are popular name in the country. He created the character of the singing donkey Gardav Das along with his brother cartoonist Jayanto for Indian children's magazine Target. He is currently the National Creative Director at Reliance Industries Limited. His animation series named Breaking Toons appear on the group's channel. Nilab was born in Lucknow and started his career as a crime reporter and later worked as a cartoonist and illustrator for another magazine. He moved on to become a staff artist at the Times of India, where he grew on to become National Arts and Illustration Editor. At the Times Group, Nilab collaborated with editor Jag Suraiya to create a popular comic strip, Dabiya Man. Those comic strips were collected in a book, Dabiya Man's Duniya. Nilab is one of those illustrators who has seen the transformation from analog to digital world, from pencil and paper drawings to stylus and tablet live cartooning. We are here to talk about cartoons as chronicles of history with Nilab Banerjee, who's seen it all. Welcome to Passion Talk, Nilab.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here. Hello, everybody. Namaskar. Be safe, be happy in these times of lockdown. And the thing is, cartoons talk themselves. So it's a very difficult task to talk about cartoons, yet I'll try to do a fair job about it. Amin, thank you for giving me such an introduction. And yes, it's also there that I am the bridge generation who started drawing cartoons with pen and paper. I have grown up between India ink, pencil, rubber, ivory sheets and ideas of cartoons. And now I have, in fact, what started with pen and paper is now in softwares. So, I mean, it's a long journey definitely, but an enjoyable one. But before I start talking more about cartoon, here, Mask India, please be safe. And our message to India is, keep social distancing, even if booth shops are open. And be happy, be safe, and fight Corona. Corona harega, India jeetega. There with it.
Lovely pleasure having you, Nilab, on Passion Talk. It's a lovely concept by Times Passion Trail and the Times of India.
Thank you, Times of India, for starting Passion Trail because it connects with so many of us who have small passions about traveling, I mean, off-road driving, drawing skills, music, etc., etc. Hobby is a very important thing for a person because if you go into a personality, a person is identified by what is his personal thing. So a hobby is a very personal thing. And Times of India, if it is nurturing such hobbies by using Passion Trail, like I am passionate about cartoons. I am a professional cartoonist, but it's my passion also. So I hope to see lot of many budding cartoonists, some veteran cartoonists in this Passion Trail. And we'll love to connect with them.
Lovely. And Nilab, you've seen it all. You've worked with young cartoonists, you've worked with experienced cartoonists, you've worked with established names. So take us through the journey of political cartoons. Tell us about the importance of political cartoons, of course, without forgetting the your experiences of working with Lakshman Sahab and
see,
the Common
cartoons
Man.
Are very important for India. Like, I don't know about other countries, but here we are very passionate about the movies we produce, the cricket we play, or the cricket others play, and the politics we have. We see politics everywhere, and political cartoons and politics go hand in hand. Without political cartoons and politicians, cartoonists like us would have been unemployed by now. So, thank you to be in India, which is such a colorful country, with so much of politics happening, that we at times don't have to think hard about getting a funny idea. So, I'd like to share a little bit about myself here, because me and cartoons are intertwined. We have grown up together, in the sense that my first published cartoon was when I was maybe 12 or 13 year old. I will send you the picture of that. And since then, I used to see Lakshman Sahab's cartoon. Initially, as a kid, I used to be drawn towards the drawing part of it. I mean, the drawings used to be seen so, when I could not gauge the political depth of the cartoons he used to do. So, I mean, growing up in a family where cartoon was the craft, and the entire family was inspired by Lakshman Sahab. My initial days, I used to see those cartoons drawn in black and white, and hardly used to get much colored publications, because newspapers all used to be black and white. So, I mean, those drawings, the way he used to draw it, I mean, even as a kid, I could see the effortlessness. So, I grew up admiring cartoons, admiring Lakshman Sahab, and when I got an opportunity, as you know, I started my career in a newspaper in an entirely different segment, crime reporting, which in Lucknow was a very, very different kind of ballgame at that point of time. So, but slowly I used to see funny things also, funny ideas, I started drawing my own cartoons. And as a school kid, just to enhance my pocket money, I started drawing a comic strip called Broomhead, which was for children. And there used to be a newspaper called Northern India Patrika coming out from Lucknow. So they used to print it every Sunday. And I used to get a princely sum of 40 bucks per cartoon, that comic strip I used to do. So, all my Tintin and Asterix comics, which were novelty around that time, and many other Gold Key comics and the DC comics and Indrajal comics also, a Times Book publication, they all used to be funded by that 40 bucks a week I used to earn drawing that cartoon. So, I mean, newspapers adopted me at a very young age to do the cartoons. But before that, as I at times say, I made the cartoons or cartoons made me. It's a very it's a question which can be answered from both the sides. So earlier in school, my canvas for practicing cartoons used to be the classroom's blackboard, where I used to have a roaring audience from my classmates, and at times I have had had a brush in the wrong side of the teachers also. So, Lakshman Sahab, was the background where I wanted to set a prelude to coming to Lakshman Sahab.
Okay.
So, when I joined Times of India, my first thing was to go and meet him. But I had joined in Hindi, in Delhi, and I was a young cartoonist who had joined Times of India as a group staff illustrator. And that time, I mean, this was early 80s and 88, I think. Times of India was harboring these huge battle frigates of R.K. Lakshman, Mario Miranda, and even Sudhir Bhai, that is Sudhir Telang. Sudhir Telang used to be with NBT, Mario Saab used to be with Economic Times. Mario Miranda needs no introduction. Everybody has seen his detailed drawings and cartoons. He used to be never actively involved with political cartoons, but his drawings and the detailed, funny sketches of Goa, Bombay and other places, they are sold as decorative tiles now. And his artworks are, you know, I mean, God bless him. I mean, he's a history now, but somewhere we keep on going back to him for references. The way he could clean out a funny sequence from usual day life. And that was Mario Miranda Sahib. He was working with the Economic Times at that time. I think it was a freelance thing. And R.K. Lakshman was the chief political cartoonist for Times of India, and Sudhir Talan was there. And they were all big wigs. And I was, I had just come back from a small town, Lucknow, and joined the Delhi office. So, ultimately, to meet Mr. Lakshman, I had to travel to Bombay. So, because he was operating from there. So, I mean, and that too after quite a long time, I mean, of joining Times of India and after doing many cartoons. So, I was lucky that he noticed, he said that, who is this chap who is drawing cartoons here? And that too, he's brushing into political cartoons also. So, that was a wonderful experience. He gave me some tips, a little sternly, but he gave me some tips and which I found to be very, very valuable later on. Like, if you notice, I mean, R.K. Lakshman cartoons, he never goes away from the basic anatomy. He never extends or he never distorts facial features too much. The way he captures a facial feature, a characteristics of a man's face or a woman's face, I mean, it's a Lakshman caricature doesn't finish with the face. It's a complete body language he represents. Like when he used to do Rajiv Gandhi, it was from head to toe. The Rajiv Gandhi personality used to be 100% in the drawing he used to do, like Indira Gandhi used to do. I think that the present, among present politicians, there are hardly any which he drew. I think he did L.K. Advani and maybe, I don't even know if he did Modi ji at all. So, I mean, his way of capturing, his Amitabh Bachchan used to be excellent. I mean, a few lines he used to draw Amitabh Bachchan. So, if you see, he never used to go away much from the basic anatomy of a thing. He never used to distort faces too much, distort anatomy too much. And of course, he was a brush person. And his brush, powerful brush strokes, where somewhere the signature, I mean, it's said among cartoonists and others also, that a Lakshman cartoonist doesn't need a byline. I mean, even if he doesn't sign R.K. Lakshman, you will know that, oh, this is a R.K. Lakshman cartoon. So, coming back to, I mean, Lakshman Sahab, not only did he do political cartoons, but he created some very commercial characters also.
Now, coming to Lakshman Saab's work, which was a reminder of events. How Common Man, his political and social cartoons became reminder of our events. I mean, you look at them and you know what was happening in that day and age.
Exactly, exactly. Now, like Common Man is an icon of India. I mean, even if you go to a journalist who has studied India or communication in India, he will know Common Man. Common Man is the only Asian cartoon character or safely India's cartoon character who has a sculpture done which is there in Worli Bombay. Worli Mumbai sea face has a sculpture of Lakshman's Common Man facing the sea. So, I mean, but apart from the Common Man, he also did a famous character called Gattu.
Yes.
That was for Asian Paint. So, I mean, that is not too publicized right now. That was a young boy with a paintbrush. Yeah. And I think it was done in the same time when the Amul girl took birth. So, yes, I mean, a cartoonist knows no boundaries, so does creativity. So his creativity were many, like he used to illustrate his brother's book, like the Malgudi days book. If you see, you will see lovely Lakshman illustration. And he has fascination for crows. So his crow drawings are exceptional. If you haven't seen it, you must have a look at it.
Definitely. And which are the common man cartoons that really stand out for you, that according to you best explain that specific day and age, that
see moment in history? To begin with, we will go back to a Lakshman cartoon which definitely was done during Rajiv Gandhi. Here I am taking the cartoons from this book, Just in Time, which was a Times of India publication, and I co-authored the book. So, I mean, there are a lot of selections of nice cartoons in this. So, here if you see this Exhibit 1, which I want to show, you will find that the Common Man and Mrs. Common Man. By the way, Common Man was a very much a family man, and there used to be a Mrs. Common Man also. So, they are standing. One side we have the grand old political party Congress with Rajiv Gandhi, and here separatism, corruption, crime, etc., etc. It's all bound in that. And on other side we have V.P. Singh, and for those who came in later, V.P. Singh became our Prime Minister also, and he was first a Congress party member, and he split and launched his own party. So we have the others, vote for front. So, and here the common man is doing a comment, whom to pick, who is the less of the evil. So this choice is still there. At times, I mean, in present times also, if you see, there is a big party. There are usually before every election, there is a front which is to be formed. But even before forming, either the front collapses or during election something happens. So 30 years ago, the story was the same, and this cartoon depicts the same thing. So cartoons keep on happening in their new form. But somewhere, India's politics remain the same. Like this cartoon has great brushwork. It has V.P. Singh and entire left front or the United Front in a disarray. And the Congress party having its own problem. The common man can't decide which way to go. So, I mean, if you look at... I started with this Lakshman cartoon because it's important. If you look at this cartoon... I mean, perhaps if you go to the 2019 election, you will find the same thing. I mean, the basics of politics and political cartoons, that's why somewhere it's a little easy in political cartoons in India also. Because certain things don't change. If you pick up a Lakshman's pothole cartoon, which was done 30 years ago, it works today also. I mean, the municipal corporations could not still fail to fill up the potholes even after 30 years of advancement.
Precisely, I mean, some of the Lakshman cartoons remain meaningful even if published
today. They will look
today.
Fresh out of the mint, believe me. I mean, the cartoons on corruption, there is a cartoon, if you show it now, a bank robber is in the bank trying to loot a bank. Now, this cartoon, I mean, I don't need to say anything at all. If I publish it in 2018, it will make sense. In 19, it will make a sense. And if I print it right now also, with non-performing assets overriding banks, I mean, the bank manager is telling the robber, why loot? Take a loan. I mean, there are other ways of swindling and emptying a bank, basically. So, I mean, it doesn't need much of an explanation. How relevant this cartoon is now. So somewhere Lakshman foresaw these bank scams happening 30-40 years ago. So I mean, you can say, so political cartoonists can be soothsayers also somewhere. But this time in a negative way, I wish those things don't happen and we learn from cartoons and stop doing all these things. But it happens and the cartoon is in front of you. You see, it's a black and white cartoon done many years ago and it's still having the same relevance.
Nila, tell me how these characters, say Common Man is an example you took, Amul Girl is another example you cited as two Indian iconic cartoon characters. How these characters continue to evolve even if the creator is not alive?
Yeah, that's very important.
Talk us through the evolution of these two characters.
It has happened worldwide. So, as a cartoonist, I'll say that we are lucky to be in India, who has its a country which has adopted foreign comic characters also, cartoon characters also, and we have our Indian characters also. In language press also, there are very strong characters, and in mainstream English, Hindi, you will find them. I'll start with Disney, sir. So now, Mr. Walt Disney, long time ago, came up with Mickey Mouse. But now, Mickey Mouse was an American character. But now, you see in ice cream stalls and children geometry boxes, you will find the same thing. Even before Disney became operational in India, we used to see Mickey Mouse very much in India. But we have our own characters. Like we have, let's say, the Common Man is a very, very political character. It's a very, I wouldn't say serious, but it's meant for a particular age group. But look at the Amul Girl. Amul Girl has taken, Amul Girl was devised long time ago, long time ago. And, but if you look at the avatar the Amul Girl has taken, anything happens and there is a big holding of the Amul Girl inside that situation, even if it is the surgical strike, even if it is a cricket match India wins, even if it is a big deal with Facebook where it invests in India, you will find the Amul Girl talking about it and talking in a very sweet, nice way with selling the butter, actually. So, Amul ad campaign is very, very topical, and somewhere it's topical cartoon if not political. So apart from the Common Man, the Amul Girl is a very strong character which India has, and so many others. Like in comic book we have our own Chacha Chaudhary. I mean, everybody knows about Chacha Chaudhary Sadhu, and of course, I mean, I would like to pitch in about Gardab Das. I mean, lovely to hear from about Gardab Das from you after so many years. Yes, we want to revive that. But coming to how cartoons evolve, and I wish the Common Man had also, evolution of Common Man is that your question was that after the creator is no more, the character goes on. Yes, definitely. Because the longevity of a character is, in Hindi, wo amar hote hain. In a few years ago, when Times of India was having 175 years celebration, so we wanted to do something about it, and a stamp was being made. So I was part of it, and the concept was mine, which turned out to be the 175 year postal stamp, and it was released by the President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee. So there, the brief given to me was that Times of India is not 175 year old, it is 175 year young. So now in this drawing, if you see, we are showing the Common Man, half of the avatar is the old one. But if you take the Lakshman devised Common Man now, so nobody wears a dhoti and coat now, not much in the cities at least. So he is walking into a new avatar. So if you see, the Common Man was such a strong character that in the drawing you can see that he is coming out wearing a jeans and a very casual dress and with a loafer on and this kind of thing. So he became 2019, 2018, whatever. Similar with the Amul Girl, I was happy to see an Amul ad recently where I am seeing the Amul Girl has left her line drawing avatar. Now she has become a 3D animated cartoon, and that Amul Girl is playing with kids who are basically the live kids who are shot in the same situation and using computer graphic and CG Amul Girl is placed in between. I was so happy. In fact, that is a wonderful step ahead for a cartoon character like the Amul Girl. Because I feel that she is no more representative of Amul. She is a part of our, I mean, she is in our consciousness despite whatever brand she is selling. So yes, cartoon characters outlive the people who create them.
Okay. Nilad, take us through the process behind a cartoon. Talk to us about how you think of a character, how do you put across your thoughts, how do you convey the message?
That's a very interesting question. So I'll talk about the few cartoon characters I had developed. My first cartoon character as a kid was Broomhead. So the same chap who used to come every Sunday in the children's section of a newspaper and earned me 40 bucks. So that was the beginning of it. So that character was, I had a class fellow who had this straight, thick hair. I mean, whatever he used to do, I mean, his hair will never sit down. They will grow vertically up. So he was the inspiration of this. That's why the name was Broomhead. I mean, his head used to look like a big broom. So, I mean, that was the first. So, characters at times are inspired. Walt Disney was inspired about Mickey Mouse by looking at a shadow of a mouse which has crept up into his garage apartment and was taking a bite of the cheese. This is a heard story. So, I mean, authenticity has to be. But it's a, anyways, it's an inspiring story. Similarly, my first political cartoon character, which ran in Times of India for 15 years, was we partnered. Jack Suraiya was there. He was our edit page editor and a very, very creative humor writer also. So, Jack Suraiya wrote a middle talking about George W. Bush. Here we talk about Donald Trump now, and he is giving good occupation to a lot of cartoonists and meme makers. So, doing whatever, by just being himself. So, similarly, he is not the first one. Bush Jr., when he came into power in America, so he used to also come up with lines like, we will smoke them out, make no mistakes, I will crush the entire world just to kill, take out a terrorist or something. I'll attack this country because they are having WMDs, etc., etc. So, I mean, he was a very potent character for a cartoonist. So, when Jug wrote a piece, article on George W. Bush, and it came to me for illustration, that okay, we have to do an illustration. But the way he wrote it, I mean, the entire piece lent itself to a comic strip. So, we had a discussion, and thanks, Jug. He was so open to idea, because in edit page used to be such a serious, serious business at that time. I mean, nobody could even think of even posting a smiley there. But thanks to Jug, he said that, no, this time we will convert the entire article into a comic strip, and we and that's how WMN started, the first political cartoon strip in India, which went on for the two terms, 10 years. George Bush was there in White House, and after that it converted into Desh Ka Neta and continued for another 4-5 years. So in that strip we used to talk about all netas, all characters, everything from, and the good thing about a healthy cartoon column or a cartoon strip is that how many people hate you. So we were nearly sued by the left, we were nearly sued by the right and the center also. So, and whatever lies in between, left, right and center. So, I mean, we used to get so many of hate mail and so many of appreciation. So, the Times of India editors, one day decided that the males, the the brickbats are more interesting than the comic strip. So, for many years, we started printing the comments. I mean, how horrible this idea can be. You are Marxist, you are racist, you are, you know, scum of the earth, you are aliens, you are whatever, whatever. Even Captain Haddock wouldn't have so many explicit than we used to get in those mails. So we started printing them. So as soon as we started printing the hate mails stopped. So that's another part of it.
Important, Nilab, you touch this aspect because tell me something. At times, interpretations are not in your hands. You give out a thought, but how it's going to be interpreted is not in the hands of the
cartoonist. I'll tell you, there are so many cartoons we do, and one has to be careful. Like, sensitivities are very high these days. I mean, earlier were the years of innocence. Maybe you could have done something and people would have taken it in their stride. But somewhere we have become more sensitive. There are certain issues we cannot talk about. I mean, we have to look right from being politically correct. So, you know, in a political cartoon or a social cartoon, it's very difficult to be politically or socially correct. But one has to. So, I mean, somewhere, when you do a cartoon, you are very cautious, you are over-cautious. Mm-hmm. Over-cautious cartoons lose the fun, by the way. But still, those cartoons are made. We look at everything. But now, when you draw a cartoon and it's published, the good and bad thing is that people see their own meaning in it. I mean, maybe you have tried to translate the cartoon in 500 different ways that, okay, I mean this by doing this cartoon or that. But they come up with an entirely different view on a cartoon. And at times, it's really a learning experience because they compliment me that, Nilab, you did this cartoon and that angle was very well. It was resonating that particular thing. Arey Baba, I never even thought about it. But they have seen, so I politely say that, oh yes, I mean, I researched well, etc., etc. And at times, there are negative things that why did you show that particular person like this? This amounts to body shaming. This amount to racism. Mm-hmm. This amounts to whatever, whatever. So, I mean, at times, the unthought things also carry ideas which people pick up, which is good and bad also. Mm-hmm. So that's why once a cartoon is made, it takes its own life. I mean, it has its own personality. When out in the when it is published and it's among people, the translations are, you cannot control how a person would react to one cartoon. They take their own life. So that's why I again say cartoons make me or cartoons make the cartoonist somewhere.
Nilab, coming to this point, do you think that cartoons are done with a sense nowadays to evoke a particular reaction? I mean, are this cartooning and lampooning the same? Have we forgotten the difference? If you can just talk to us about that.
See, I mean, here we should start our conversation somewhere like the difference between humor, satire, lampooning, and somewhere plain caricatures. Now, caricatures are very safe. They are the cartoonic representation of a personality. So, they may not be saying something. They are only a representation of the person. But humor, satire and lampooning. Lampooning is when you are laughing at someone. And it's a little cruel also. And good humor and satire is when everyone laughs. You are not laughing at anyone. You are laughing with something. So, that is the difference the cartoonist should, or any humor or satirist should pay a little attention to. Because see, here we, if we self-censor ourselves, we keep on talking about freedom. That we should have all the entire freedom of, it's a democratic country, we should have freedom of expression, we should have freedom to do our cartoons, we should have freedom to express our thoughts. But with the right of freedom, we should also try to keep a mind that we are not abusing that freedom also. I mean, we will not start taking a bath in the
in an open area, or let's say people do that. I mean, wrong example. But there are so many things we have to be self-conscious about. We have to self-censor ourselves. Mm-hmm. That, okay, this is something I'll do. I mean, with the concept of Bharat Mata, I will not do anything which goes against it. With the emblem of our country, I will not do anything which shows it disrespectfully. Nobody will have to censor me on that. So now, these are the things one has to be a little safe about. So, if you know how to retain your freedom of expression, but also think about not abusing it, you will automatically know the difference between good humor, where everybody is laughing, you are not targeting a person, and lampooning somewhere is targeting a person. So, I mean, I don't support that. I believe in something where everybody is laughing, and in a very, very secular manner.
Very well put, Nilab. I wanted to bring forth how much is the medium of dissemination nowadays change the way you think of your cartoons? Because it was newspaper earlier, then it became digital, and to today. The medium of dissemination, does that change the way you think about a cartoon?
Here, it's a little descriptive answer. And the medium has changed along with the changes which has happened around us. I mean, having said that, my first thing is like now none of us go and stand in those long queues for a railway reservation or a flight ticket or even to pay bills. So after the 2016 digital revolution which Jio brought in, we are empowered by wideband and broadband. We are empowered by our streaming quality. The data is, I mean, we all get, I mean, you can see everybody watching television or cricket matches on their small cell phone, very affordable. What happened like a few years ago, if you, I mean, see our Facebooks used to carry only written messages. After that, people started posting photographs. Earlier, if you had posted a photograph, it used to buffer, nothing used to open. But now, if you see, the language has turned to video. Everybody is posting video because you are data empowered now. Our speed and our bandwidth has increased somewhere. So, with this digital revolution, there is a effect on cartooning also. Absolutely. I'll come to that how. So, when we used to draw manually with pen and paper, I mean, the canvas for cartoon was a newspaper or a magazine which used to be printed. But if you see slowly the onset of digital, with the digital revolution started in India from 2016, with data streaming so much, you will find a digital avatar of everything. I mean, even entertainment has gone that way. In fact, during this lockdown, this I mean, we are recording this program is because we are digitally enabled. We were digitally enabled. That's why so many things can happen, including the symptom checker of government like Arogya app, or if you look at so many things. I mean, life has become a little easy in lockdown because we have been digitally empowered. So now this digital thing played a little differently for cartoonists. Those who used to draw cartoons manually or in a Photoshop or a different way, they got, I mean, they were never, you know, held hostage by one particular magazine or a newspaper, or everybody started posting their stuff in social media. And at time, a cartoonist who is not even, who is a freelancer, is getting so many likes and shares in social media that, I mean, and somewhere the ideas also don't get diluted. So he, it's his pure cartoon. What he or she wants to do is right there in the social media. And it's, I mean, the freedom of expression somewhere become a true story with the digital empowerment. But how it happened to me was like I was a print cartoonist till 2014, and I chose to come into the digital media. I was one of the first cartoonists who skipped a real nice place. I mean, what more can it be than Times of India to come and join the digital format of doing my work. So here I found that I was very empowered. Mm-hmm. Here I can do animations, I can do skits, mm-hmm. I can do, my cartoons can at last come and talk and dance and speak. So every cartoonist's dream is to make their cartoon characters talk and move and do. So that became true. That's why I do a lot of animations now. Mm-hmm. I started with 2D animations, but now I'm doing the 3D animations, which are much more fun to watch. You have got many much freedom to that.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, digitalization somewhere democratized the cartoons. Now one doesn't need a particular career to carry your cartoon. You can be, the cartoons can be your own career. Mm-hmm. You put them out in social media, people will, half the world is in social media, so people will like it, and your cartoon will get more, perhaps more viewership than if you would have done it few years ago in a particular publication or things like that. So yes, somewhere digitalization along with helping out so many and giving us so many facilities has helped cartoonists a lot.
Yes, and coming to this Nilab, democratization of the skill, and now everybody posting their work online, I wanted to bring very important topic here. From the cartoons being our chronicles, are now memes our chronicles? What's your take on this entire meme making thing? Are those
excellent question? Excellent question. I was just waiting for you to ask this. See, what has happened now? When I meant democratization of the cartoons. For earlier, you need a person who used to draw, who was good in drawing, who could make a character, who could draw a particular politician, who could draw Rahul Gandhi or who could draw Narendra Modi, to be a cartoonist.
Mm-hmm.
So now, with digitalization, like, we all have creativity inside us, and we just want to get a way to express it. If you see, cartoons are taking a different forms of memes. Now, you don't need to be a cartoonist. You pick up a picture of anyone you want to, add a voice blur. I mean, even I do memes. I mean, the memes you are looking at right now were done some time ago, and they are stills, but I do lot of celluloid, the moving memes also, and they are fun to watch. At times, I want to give up my drawing to do full-time memes. Memes are very powerful, and they are the cartoons of the future. Because here, you can find anybody who can do, with help of some softwares, can do a cartoon. Anyone who has an idea can do a cartoon. With the digital pad, with our cell phones, where you can draw, with the softwares, where you can morph things, where you can put blurbs on people's, or the stickers you can use on faces. These are all forms of cartoons. So somewhere cartoons are evolving, cartoons are becoming more people. People are making cartoons within their families by using stickers, by adding a long nose to the uncle's face, or adding a little decoration to the aunt's face, etc., etc. After all, these are all an avatar of caricature and cartoon, which everybody is doing. You don't need a political cartoonist or a expert cartoonist to guide you. You do your own cartoon. So somewhere, I'm all for it, because here I can see for last 40 years, I have been eating, drinking and doing cartoons. So I am so happy that cartoons have opened up and it's gone to the people. Like music or like reading or like writing. You can do. So that's why when you are doing this passion trail and you are picked up cartooning is something like they say in a newspaper, there is news and there is views. Edit page is talking about between the lines. But even cartoons have their own between the line areas. So that is open to interpretation to anyone who is looking at it. So this is such a creativity and a brain exercise. I am happy that Times Passion Trail has a group of cartoonists who are being brought together, looking forward to see actually some cartoons from them also and share their thoughts. So it's, I think cartoon is going to be a very important platform, and here I'd like to extend my answer by a little bit if you give me another minute. Creativity and cartoons are one of the good paying out of box professions now. If you have ideas, you can produce. Production is with CG, computer graphics, with so many other facilities which comes with digitalization, which comes with softwares. Now it is just the ideas, your storytelling capacities, your narrative part, what you want to do, a funny cartoon, a funny story, a satire. I mean, making it has become easy.
Yeah.
And if you see, we get to see so many lovely contents, and content is going to be the king in the coming time. Of course, video format will be there because everybody wants to see things moving, and video is more interesting. It still will definitely be there. And humor content, because with the world, especially post-COVID world, I pray that it's going to be easy for all of us. But yes, you will need humor break in the times to come, because they may not be very easy times. So to, you know, let the pressure off, watch cartoons, watch lovely humor films, and they are only going to help you in keeping the balance somewhere. I mean,
thank you so much for taking time out and talking to us at Times Passion Trail. It has been a pleasure listening to your thoughts of evolution of cartoons over the years, cartoons as chronicles, and your journey from paper and pen to stylus and tablet.
Thank you, Amin. Thank you for having me. And while talking to you, I was thinking of a cartoon idea. I had started doing it also. So I will be devoting this particular cartoon to Times Passion Trail and this conversation.
Thank you so much everyone for watching this edition of Passion Talk. Our series continues with many such amazing masterclasses lined up, with each having as exciting and immersive a personality and discussion as it was with Nilab today. Join in and live your passion. See you.